This is former Indiana basketball player Brian Evans, and you're listening to Indiana Sports Beat with Jim Coyle.
Today's guest is brought to you by Reynolds Family Dentistry of Sellersburg. You need a $1 million smile for those championship photos, and that's exactly what you'll get with Reynolds Family Dentistry.
Welcome back to Indiana Sports Beat with Coyle Larry. Coming to you here on this Tuesday, June 23rd, from the Golf Club at Eagle Point Studios, powered by Rivals. Go to thehoosier.com. Mo Creek, how are you, sir?
Doing good. How are you?
Good, good, man. Everybody looking forward to sports returning, and the TBT is set to fill that bill. And you've been a mainstay of that league and back again with the team this year. And, man, it's a different weird year, but I don't know if the players are, but I know that the fans are looking forward to this more than any other time ever.
I know there's going to be a lot of people watching just because of what's going on. I mean, even though they can't come into the gym still because, you know, of what's going on, there's going to be a lot of people watching it on the TV.
Absolutely. Absolutely, and that's great for the league itself, for the tournament, at the exposure, but also for the guys that are playing it as well. Looking forward to it. You know, a lot of things we talk about here is it's becoming bigger and bigger for teams to, or schools to put kind of teams together. Indiana, we've talked about this. We need to get an Indiana team put together for this thing.
Yeah, they've been doing that for trying to do it for a minute now, but. You know, it just
haven't
really came through. Hopefully they do.
Yeah, that would be great. Now, and Ramey Amos playing with you on your team, right?
Yeah.
Looking forward to Ramey, a former Hoosier as well. But who are some of the other guys that are on your squad?
Marcus King from Central Michigan. We got Jamel Artis. He played in the NBA for a little bit. The Orlando Magic. We got Eric Thompson. He played in Pacific. He's professional overseas. We got a lot of pieces. We got a lot of pieces that a lot of people don't know about. That makes us a sneaky team, but a good team.
Yeah, I got to keep the weapons under the radar. This tournament has really grown in stature, not only amongst people who watch it, but among the players. This is kind of a thing that people want to play in this thing.
You got to play your best basketball every game. You can't, come in and slouch and think you're going to win this tournament because, it's for big money. And, also playing for exposure. Like I said, there's going to be a lot of people watching. You never know who's watching. You might get a call from somebody just because of playing in the TBT, and you got a lot of NBA pros in the TBT. You got a lot of overseas athletes in the TBT, and it's just good. This is the best basketball other than in the NBA, which we'll go on after. But this is the second best.
And we talk about all these teams and looking forward to that. But what's the – and you talk about the draw of being – so there's so many different opportunities that it offers, being seen as one of those, but making some money is another of those as well. How difficult is it normally in a normal – not this year, obviously, because of the pandemic, but with the overseas schedules, how hard is it to make this – is that one of the – things you have to overcome, and like say putting an IU team together, but just getting a team together at all, it seems like guys are kind of scattered out.
Yeah, I mean, it's basically about who you know and who you can kind of trust. You know what I mean? Like it's tough even getting in because you gotta earn your way in too. So those are like the things that probably can turn a team off. Like what you got to do to get in it. You got to, get your fan base. You got to have, the supporting cast to even get you in it, which IU should not have a problem doing because, there's the, you got the fans for that, for sure. find people to play. You know what I mean? It's people that's overseas that, you know what I'm saying, probably wouldn't make it back home and stuff like that. So you got to think, like, all that stuff comes into perspective when you're putting in a team. And it just happens that, you know, we got guys that are finishing up just right around that time with TBT and don't have to go back so soon so they can play on the TBT. That's why we got this squad that we got.
In the with the pandemic this year, and in the immortal words of Allen Iverson, do you guys practice?
We'll get down in Ohio probably days before. It's the only teams practicing right now, and that's fine. But you know, we'll get down there on the 30th. We'll do a couple practices here and there, try to figure out our lineups, try to put some plays in, and you know, so get ready for this thing. We got a tough team coming up, and Team Hines, they're one of the top teams in it. So, you know, taking it one game at a time. We only got 4 games to win it all, so just, you know what I'm saying, let's be easy with it and take it one game at a time and try to get this thing. And, yeah, we'll start June 30th.
Now, there are some big time teams in this thing, which makes it fun, of course. But the Ohio State team, do they have kind of an advantage because they're kind of getting to play everything at home there?
Yeah. I mean, that's what's happening when the thing, you know, like it's luckily there's no fans in the gym, so I mean. They do have an advantage because it's their hometown. They get the practice and stuff right now and everything else, get ready for it more than anybody else. But at the same time, you know, they want it. So they should, you know, they should have the advantages. Because there would be nowhere that, you know, that you can go that somebody doesn't have a team. So it's okay. You know, they picked the most safest spot with the COVID-19. They don't have that many cases in Ohio and stuff like that, so I think that was another reason why they put it in Ohio and that only that spot. And you know, it's fine. We'll call it a mutual grounds because the fans not in there.
Hey, and the fact that this thing is being played under the cloud of the COVID-19 pandemic, any concerns of you or any of the guys you've talked to about participating in this?
I think we're fine. I mean, if it was a problem, I don't think people were playing it. You know, they're getting this team is like we're getting tested right now for it. You know, we got a home kit for it, and then when we get down there, we're gonna get tested again. So there's no hiding from it. There's no like, oh, you know, like. Somebody can catch it down there or something like that. Nah, because every team got to get tested when they get down to Ohio, too. So I don't think there's no concerns. I think everybody's excited to play in the tournament. I am, too.
Yeah, obviously everybody's looking forward to it. They wouldn't be going. They were able to get it put together. So it looked like there was just a lot of excitement all leading all the way. There were other leagues like baseball and some of these other are having problems getting started. Didn't look like the TBT was having many problems. Everybody wanted to play in this. There didn't seem to be any dissension whatsoever.
Yeah, everybody missed basketball, so one way to get us back into playing and playing, having to play your best game in a TBT tournament where millions of people are going to be watching on ESPN. So, yeah, I feel like everybody should be excited and ready for it.
I noticed in the NBA in their attempt to come back out, there are several players, including people like Trevor Ariza, who may not play, who are opting out and coming back. Obviously, I know you're not in that situation, but if you were, can you imagine not playing?
Yeah, I get it from some guys' perspective. You know what I mean? It's not like the NBA is going to be testing like every day. These guys don't have restrictions like we have. Like, see, some of the rules of the tournament is, like, you can't leave your hotel once you step in your hotel, you can't leave back out. You know what I mean? So, that's a rule just to stay safe of the COVID-19. You know what I mean? So,
right. What are some of the other safety procedures they have put in place to make sure that they keep you guys, basically just kind of keep you quarantined off from everybody else?
Just basically staying with your team. Basically, you can't leave the hotel. You can't, for eating purposes, I think they getting stuff ordered to the house, ordered to the hotel, or somebody got to go get it for you. It's a lot. But they thought about this stuff when they come, I mean, because they're not trying to give nobody no harm. You know what I mean? So they thought really well about this.
Right. So obviously guys are very comfortable in playing in this. So how long, if you were to win a TBT championship, how long would it, how long does it last?
The first game is July 4th and the final game will be the 14th.
Okay. So we got a 10 day run there. So you could be quarantined in the hotel there for a little less than 2 weeks. So not a bad deal. We get to wake up every day to room service, but what are you looking forward to? How do you feel about your team this year? I mean, I know you're behind them, but you guys played pretty well last year. You kind of got on a run.
Yeah, I'm really excited because we got the same team, but we added on a couple more pieces that we may need. I'm always excited, you know what I'm saying, to get back with my brothers and to play with them again, play for the Cause, play for Jermaine. We're playing for a lot. And I know we're a hungry group because, of course, nobody really knows about us yet again. And if they do, they kind of like not respecting it. But we felt this way. It was from last year, and we surprised a lot of people by coming in, just playing our type of basketball, what we do, and being nitty gritty and getting wins. So, you know, this time we were expecting to win this thing. I mean, even though everybody else is not expecting us to win, we want to expect to win it.
Hey, you have to. If you don't think you can win, nobody will, right? And then, of course, we'll have to get Ramey Abel on here to talk to him about that. But looking at some college basketball news, I saw that the expected number one pick in the draft this year, Cade Cunningham, has decided to go ahead and stay or keep his commitment to Oklahoma State. And even though they have a postseason ban, they cannot play in the tournament. Can you imagine if you were the number one pick, the team you're going to go to does not have a chance to play in the NCAA tournament?
I couldn't, but I get where he's going with it. I think he has some family ties up there, and even if they what I'm trying to say is that he might just want to go to straight to the NBA. You know what I mean? Getting right with play his best basketball with his family up there, go straight to the NBA. I mean, what better way to do it than not playing the NCAA tournament? I couldn't do it because that's all my hard work and dedication. I'm trying to make the tournament. I'm trying to get seen some more. But I mean, he's had a lot of exposure since he was a kid. So, you know, these kids now are just trying to get straight to the NBA as quick as possible. Some people are taking the G League route. Some people are still taking the college route. But, you know, as quickly as possible with these kids.
Yeah, and basketball is changing. The college game is changing so quickly in regards to who's going to go pro, who doesn't go pro, how they get there. The rule doing away with the one and done, well, that should happen here, I think, in the next year or so. But he's a perfect situation. He has got so many options of which he could choose, but going to college is one of those. He's going to do that, but not playing the NCAA tournament, that would suck. But basketball is so different now. It's become college basketball. It's become a business, more of a business than ever. And we see the same things that are going on in some degree, but it's becoming almost a quasi pro type deal.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's becoming a big deal. You know, it's a lot of people that are doing a lot in college basketball now, like trying to figure out if they should, what college they should go to now. And we hear Mikey with the HBCU thing now. We're hearing, people not even going to college, people, you know, starting to get paid in college now. It's a lot going on.
Yeah, I mean, just imagine, just since you've been out, which has not been that long, I mean, in the grand scheme of things, now we're looking at the possibility of players being able to transfer wherever they want, whenever they want, one time. And you just mentioned getting paid, the name, image, likeness. To me, I think that's just going to be a bigger problem for college athletics than it's going to be boom, because you don't have that many kids that it really affects. It's a small percentage. But I think it's going to end up just being not a good thing for college sports.
Yeah, but I mean, kids.
But I understand the other side of it too.
I was about to say, kids are starting to realize now, like, what it is. You got to think about it. Like, you put on somebody else's jersey. Like, I have a jersey. My jersey's selling. That's millions and millions of dollars. Where is that going to, you know? And I guess people are starting to see the business side of it now and starting to figure out, like, hey, we're not getting the dime of it for just, you know, so we're going to school for it, but we, you know, so that's what the scholarship is for, yes, but, you know, kids is kind of struggling now. So, you know, it goes hand in hand. Hopefully it gets straight to the point where everything
runs
smoothly.
Absolutely. And now when the tournament gets going, we'll be following you guys, and we'll probably try to get you on here as the tournament goes on. We'll check in with and talk about the games, if that's all right.
Oh yeah, of course. I'm always around, so whenever you're ready, I'm free.
Well, man, we wish you guys the best of luck, you and Ramey, of course, and the entire team. We'll look forward to talking to him soon as well. But looking forward to it getting started, man. The TBT gets underway on July 4th. Hopefully, Moat Creek can bring home the title this year, man. That would be awesome. Good luck, brother.
I appreciate you.
This is Jim Coyle from Indiana Sports Beat with Coyle and Leary. Indiana Sports Beat is now a part of the Rivals Network. You can go to thehoosier.com to sign up. It's free. Catch the show there each day live or at your convenience. You can also like or follow us on Facebook, follow the show's rebroadcast, anywhere you podcast. If we're not on a radio station where you live, we should be. Let your local station know they need to carry Indiana Sports Beat with Coyle and Leary, or simply go to thehoosier.com.